I had this huge problem when I started photography years ago. I was so passionate, but I was a salesman selling websites to hotels, and I was taking photography after hours. And I kept telling my customers how much I love photography, and I was in the hotel business. One day, I met this hotel, the Hotel Litre, a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful four-star hotel close to Saint-Germain-des-Prés. And the assistant manager said, you know what? I love you, what you're doing with your photography. We're looking for new photos of Paris in black and white to put in our corridors. Could I hire you to take a lot of nice photos of Paris in black and white? I will give you like $2,000. It was something like this. And I was like so happy, but I had a huge problem is that I did not know how to do black and white. But I was so blown away. I had no idea you could make money with photography. It was the first time somebody even thought about giving me money for photography. I was so passionate about it that I was really happy someone had some kind of interest. My first photographies were not that great, but I was happy about it. So I spent days and days walking around Paris trying to do photography for this hotel. I wanted to sell my first photos, and everything I was doing was really bad. This is some of the photos that I got, and I really didn't like it. I didn't know what was wrong with it. I just did not like them. And so one day I just went there and I gave the photos to the hotel, and they gave me the money, but I knew they did not like the photo. I could see it on their face. They did not like the photo. I felt so ashamed, and I really, I don't like to not deliver a good job. And it was so bad that I said, I will never sell another photo again. I literally was gonna give up on photography. But then something incredible happened. I met this master in black and white. His name was Jean-Michel Birds, and the guy had produced so many books on photography. And I was so obsessed by his technique. So I went to see him. I said, what's your secret? How come your black and white are so amazing? I've seen all your books. I know you're selling so much photography all over the world. And he said something. He said, have you ever heard of Ansel Adams, Dodge and Burn and the zone system? I said, I've never heard about it. What is that? And he says, well, you should read Ansel Adams' book. And he sort of gave me like a very quick rundown. Oh my gosh, this completely changed my life. Overnight, I started studying everything that I could about Ansel Adams and Dodge and Burn and anything I could find to make very strong black and white. And in this video, if you stay until the end, I'm gonna reveal everything that I learned. Everything that took me months and months, I'm gonna put everything in a few minutes. So be focused and stay until the end. But in this video, I'm gonna show you how to take a boring photo and turn it into a masterpiece of black and white that you can sell worldwide in galleries. If you ever wanted to make strong black and white, this is the video you wanna watch. So let's do it. So this is a 30-second exposure I did of the Senate in Paris. I kind of like the clouds. I like the reflection. The long exposure really made the reflections. And I'm going to show you using my natural drama format. By the way, you can get this book. The link is under the video. You can get it for free. It's an actual physical book if you pay shipping and handling. And you get 2 weeks free of my mentorship where I can coach you on your photo. Crazy deal. Anyway, so here is the Senate. And how do you do this? So the first thing you do, of course, is, you convert it to black and white. So step number one is, you convert it to black and white, and then you open a shadow at plus 100, you bring down the highlights, and now the photo looks very grayish. And then very important, especially on black and white, you do what we call the black point. So what is the black point? Well, you hold on the Option key on your keyboard if you're on a Mac, or the Alt key if you're on Windows, and you move the black slider until you get, especially black and white, I like to get about 2-3% of black points. What you see here in black is pure black. There is no more information. It's just pure blackness, okay? And then the photo starts off looking okay, but that's not the Dodge and Burn. You gotta stay until the end because the magic is at the end. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold on the Option key and I'm gonna move the white slider the other way until I see some white coming on. And you see what you see here in white means that these are pixels which are 100% white. There is no more information. So then I just back it down by hand until I get something that I kind of like. And I kind of like that. At this point, I usually add a bit of contrast, but I'm not done. So that's just the basic exposure. The step number two of my natural drama formula is white balance. And white balance does work also for black and white. Check this out. If I move my white balance, look at how the photo changes, because it's basically gonna change the way the black and white is gonna be interpreted in the photo. So I wanna make the photo a bit darker. So that's kind of cool. Okay, So that's great. That's just the black and white. But then step number three is refining colors. When it comes to black and white, per my book, you can jump that. But step number four, and this is what you've been waiting for, is the dodge and burn, the incredible dodge and burn. What is dodge and burn? Well, dodge and burn comes from back in the time. So basically what Ansel Adams used to do is project his negative against a positive paper, okay? And the longer you project, the more you're gonna burn the paper with the negative. Now, what if you wanted to make something brighter? Well, then you would dodge the light. You would prevent the light from touching the paper, like using a spoon or something, and this area would go darker. And it was very hard. They would do it over and over and over again. I mean, I'm sure Ansel Adams would have loved seeing this tutorial of Lightroom, that what I'm about to show you. So now I'm going to do the Ansel Adams techniques, but the easy way. The first thing I'm going to do before we do the, I always make sure my cropping is good. I think on this one, I want to go 16 by 9. And I want to make it more symmetrical so that we have something like this. Yeah, so everything is centered like this. Yeah, that's way better. So the first thing that Ansel Adams used to do is often he used to burn the top of his photos because he wanted people to not look up too much, but look inside of the photo. So for this, we're going to go here and we're going to use a linear gradient that we're going to do on the sky like this. I could select the sky, but I don't want to because I think the linear gradient is going to give me a better result. So what you see in red is the, what is being selected. And basically, whatever I'm going to do, like if I lower that the exposure, it's going to do that. So that minus 0.75 is going to be at full force from the top of the photo to the red dot. And from the red dot to the white dot, it's going to be on a gradient. So you can have a short gradient or a big gradient. Personally, when I do the Ansel Adams technique, I like to do it in two passes. One pass just for the sky, but on a gradient. The problem now you can see is that it's making the Senate, the top of the Senate much darker. So trick number one, click on the three dots, click on Intercept Mask with Select Sky. That's a new AI feature in Lightroom, it's amazing. And basically what that's gonna do is that it's gonna make that gradient not affect the Senate. Check it out. Now it's only affecting the sky and not the building anymore. Isn't that crazy? Isn't that nuts? Okay, we have a big sensor dust here. I might need to go to Photoshop because it's so close to something here. So I'll show you how to get rid of that. I'm going to try to do it with this new tool here, but I'm not sure it's going to work. I'm just going to make a small selection around here. Yeah, this one is too close to the chimney. So I think at the end of the day, I went into Photoshop to erase this one. Yeah, I see it doesn't do a good job. So I'll show you. This is really tricky when you have like a sensor dust so close. I'll show you at the end how to get rid of that. It's kind of hard. Okay, so now I made the sky a bit darker. You see, if I go to my local adjustment, you can see, boom. Now, I want to make it one step further, so I'm going to go here and I'm going to add another gradient for the very top of the photo. Complete homage to Ansel Adams. He used to do that a lot. So he used to burn the very top of the photo. Okay, cool. So now that's interesting. And now I'm going to do the same thing here at the bottom. I'm going to go here, linear gradient. And I'm just going to make a one big gradient and lower a little bit the exposure like that. Maybe not so much, just at the very end. Cool. But that's not all. That is not all at all. Now, usually what I like to do is I like to add a little bit of a radial gradient right in the middle of the photo. Okay. And on this time, what I do is I add a little bit of exposure. Because I want the eyes to go inside of the photo, right? Just inside, maybe like around the clock, something. And try not to go over 0.55, 0.5. Because if you go more, it's going to be too obvious. If you go less, it's going to do nothing. I find that 0.50 is a good sweet point. Look at the difference. It's kind of subtle, but now we're like facing inside of the photo. Okay? And on this one, I can even do like, I can pretend that this, for example, this window was turned on. So something that's what I do, I take a little brush like that and let's try that. Make it very small, flow and density all the way, feather all the way, add some exposure and let's see if I can paint inside of this thing here and let's make it like really strong, like if it was turned on, okay? And then I'm gonna use the Alt option. I'm going to press Alt and the brush turns into an eraser and I'm going to erase a little bit the side. Yeah, it's way too strong. So I'm just going to lower that. Okay. Yeah, just add a bit of light there. Not so much, just a little bit there. Just to, let's see how it looks from far. Yeah, it looks weird. It's still too strong. Just add a bit of light there, just like if that thing was turned on. Don't overdo it. Usually then I take another brush. And this one is very subtle. And I just, what I want to do is I want to complexify the light. Meaning the light, I find it is a little too even, too the same on the building. So on this one, I'm going to put the flow and density in the 70s. Just add a bit of exposure. And I just want to add just a little bit of light maybe here at the bottom. And not everywhere. The whole idea is to not do it everywhere. Just in some part of the building. And again, try not to go over 0.5 or 0.6. You just want to complexify the light a little bit. See? And then once I'm happy with one brush stroke, this one is maybe a little too much. Let's lower it a bit. You want it to be very subtle, very subtle. But at the end of the day, look the difference with all the without the Dutch and burn, with the Dutch and burn. Without the Dutch and burn, with it starts to really, you know, make an effect. But that's not all. I'm going to go one more time, take a brush, make sure flow and density is in the 70s. And I'm just going to add a bit of light here. Okay, just around the water, just to make it shine a little bit more. And then maybe I sometimes like add 10 brushes. When I'm happy with a brush, I just add more. And then on this one, I maybe want to make the stripes, not all of them, but like make them a little more like that, so they are like a little more visible. And voila. So check it out, before the dodge and burn, after, totally changed the way you look at the photo. Okay, then I'm not gonna add clarity or texture everywhere, but I'm gonna do something really cool. I'm actually gonna go back here, and it's not really, at this point, not dodge and burn, but I'm gonna add a brush, and on this brush, with a flow and density like in the 90s, so pretty high, I'm gonna add a bit of texture and clarity. Yes, sir. And I'm just gonna brush that on the building to really make the building pop. But not on the water, not on the tree. I did it by mistake on the tree. Just on the building to make the bricks. I mean, when you print this photo, it really comes out. And at this point, I'm kind of happy, but I really want to have a much more contrasty photo. So something like this, maybe even crash the blacks even better. Something like that. Yeah, and that's some kind of strong black and white. I love it. I love it. You see how the dodge and burn really changed everything? And now this is going to be really hard. I'm going to try to go slow. I'm going to go to Photoshop to clean up some of the weird things in it. So here is my basic layer. I'm going to press Command J or Control J just to create another layer. I'm going to zoom in a lot on the sensor dust here. I'm going to zoom in using the zoom tool. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the pen tool, P for pen tool, and I'm going to protect this. So what I'm doing is I'm just clicking with the pen tool around the chimney. And the more you zoom in, the better. There's a bit of a halo there. And the reason I'm doing that is I'm going to use a stem tool to erase the sensor dust. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. Then I make a big thing and I click here. So now I have like a little pass. I'm going to right click on that pass and I'm going to go make a selection of 1 pixel. Okay. So now I have a selection here of 1 pixel. Then I'm going to press S for the stem tool. Pretty easy. Make my stem tool smaller. So remember in Photoshop, if you hold on the Control and Option key and you left click and right, you can make any tool smaller or bigger. So something like that. And I'm just going to press the Alt key saying I want that texture. I click here. So I'm setting that texture over here. And are you ready? Are you ready? Because I protected this, here's what happened. You see, I took some of the, I'm going to press Command D. But you see, I did it pretty well. Oh, except the 1 pixel made it a little bit blurry. So you know what? I'm just going to go back in time with Command Z. I'm going to take back the pen tool. I'm going to right click, make a selection. I'm going to make 0 instead of 1. And then I'm going to redo it. Stem tool, just click here and click here. And then make sure it's really clean. And boom, before, after. It's pretty clean, pretty clean. And nobody's going to notice even that I cut off the antenna. While I'm there, I see there's some other dust there. So I'm going to use the the spot healing brush tool. Something weird here. I don't know what happened. I'm just going to clean that up. There's another brush, another thing here. And I think I'm good. Let me see, make sure. Yeah, I think I'm good. And voila. So I'm just going to click File, Close, Save, and that's going to bring it back to Lightroom. Don't forget to get my book. The link is under this video. You just pay shipping and handling. The book itself is free, and you can get 2 weeks free of me coaching you on your photography. And this is what you get, a fully dodge and burn photo. Now, this video I'm about to show you is how to do the same thing with a blue hour photo in the Golden Gate Bridge. It's amazing.